What you got going on in the kitchen? What you got going on in the kitchen? Just two finger taps, that'll be enough. I see you whip it up, huh? Yeah. Hey Danny, what you got going on in the kitchen? I see you whipping.
Tempers, the wood, winning all these pieces of wood hit you, right? That could have killed you, put an eye out. But so many pieces of wood stuck on that wall across the way. Tore that coat up, the hat and everything. Mm-hmm. House was lean. I went home, I was scared. I remember thinking about when that bomb went off that we were supposed to ride through the buses. I remember that. Mm-hmm. But even more than that, I was thinking, the Lord is my light. And my salvation, who shall I fear the Lord? Is the strength of my life.
Yes, sir.
Whom shall I be afraid? Even when my enemies come to eat up my flesh.
Please.
You know what? I knew I wouldn't be hurt.
Mercy.
I knew I was under the everlasting arm of my Lord and Savior. I hadn't feared anything. I hadn't been more calm about anything from that day since in my life, and I've not feared anything ever since that day. So I got ready to get out of the house, but I wasn't going to leave. If we were going to stay there, I wasn't. The floor is about to catch fire on the. I took the time to put the fire.
Mercy.
Even though the house could have fell down on me, I knew I wasn't going to get there. I put on that old coat. Put on the hat and pair of pants, walked outside, and got to the door, and there's this big police. He's probably a head taller than me. Big, just bird. He just looked at me, had his little hanky. He would just wipe his face, look at me a little bit, just shook his head. I guess he wanted to see what I looked like. Just shook his head, he wouldn't say a word, just look.
Yes,
I didn't say nothing.
Fix it up,
he turned around and walked on out, and I walked. He stopped out. He walked out. By then, there's a whole bunch of people gathered. You can imagine the whole neighborhood had come out, wasn't it? But I was taking my time. Dresser, he called in. Rep, you okay? I said, I'm all right. I'll be out just a minute. We just make sure everybody out there is okay. Finally, this big officer, he said something. He said, Reverend, I'm sorry. I sure am sorry. You know, I know these people. I know these people, and I never thought they would have gone that far. I never thought they would have gone that far. I didn't say nothing. That didn't warrant any response from me that I thought. He went on a little bit further, and he said, Reverend, you know what I'd do if I was you? You know, I'd get my family, I'd get my stuff, and I would leave town. I would never come back again. I decided to say something. I said, thank you.
It's
not me.
You go back,
and you tell your plan, brother.
My mind.
You tell him that God can keep me through all this.
My mind.
Then I'm going to be in this for the duration. He's going to keep me the whole way. You go back and you tell him that.
Yes, yeah, sir.
And went on from there.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm here to tell you, I'm not a superman. Lord is blessing. I just trust the Lord, that's all I do. I have to say that word again, Deacon King, I know you out there, I just trust the Lord.
Yeah.
I learned how to live.
Yeah.
If I have anything to share with you, don't be afraid. Just believe.
Amen.
Everything will be all right. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Friend of mine, we weren't friends like some. I mean, he was friends with Ralph. They lived together. We had a mutual respect. We had a love. He's going on now. He decided to step down out of the door just for a little while to talk to us. So I'm gonna bring him up now. Come on up.
All right.
kind and my very dear friend. These churches are really loaded tonight. We've already addressed two mass meetings where you couldn't get near the churches and you couldn't get in the churches. And the same is true here. Then we have to leave immediately from here to go to St. Paul, where there's another packed church. I have experienced many things in my relatively young life, but never in my life have I had an experience like the one I'm now having here in Birmingham, Alabama. This is by far the most inspiring movement that has ever taken place in the history of this nation. Now, there are those who make history. There are those who write history. There are those who experience history. I don't know how many historians we have here in Alabama. I don't know how many of you would be able to write a history book, but you are certainly making history and you are experiencing history. And you will make it possible for the historians of the future to be able to write a marvelous chapter. Never in the history of this nation have so many people been arrested for the cause of freedom and human dignity. And did you not know that there are over 400 persons in jail right now? Now the thing that we are challenged to do is to keep this movement moving. Yes, there is power in unity and there is power in numbers. Yes. And as long as we keep going like we're going, the power structure of Birmingham will have to give in. And I'm telling you, don't you worry about your children. They're going to be all right. And don't you hold them back if they want to go to jail. But they are doing a job not only for themselves, but for all of America and all of mankind. Somewhere we read a little child should leave. You remember there was another little child, he was about 12 years old. Yeah.